from Singapore, my company, single case, physical company limited. As you may perhaps aware, in the past few months, we had some internal problems which really exposed to the news media as well. We have called you here to tell you the reason why there was a crisis in our company and how we are going to revive that and come back as the leading financial company. And also, I have to, on behalf of my company, owe an apology to the our valuable customers. So I'm sure you're going to help us, our company, to build an image what we have been over a period of time without it going to zero. So I'm sure you will be doing that importance. Thank you once again. Let me tell you what the crisis and the reason why we have. You may forget that we have been paying a very high interest compared to our company, to our credit card holders. You might wonder how a credit card holder get an interest. When you issue a credit card, what do you expect? You get a deposit. And we give a credit limit up to that deposit. And you pay it. You don't call it an interest, you call it a repayment. We know that we have planned it very well. It is, I won't say it's a tax evasion, but it was a tax plan. If you call interest, then our deposit holders have to pay tax. So we call it a repayment. And we were giving it a limit, an additional debate as well. But in the past few months, we are sorry, we don't give anything other than our valuable customers due to certain reasons. Number one, we wanted to offer a best return to our customers. What we did was, we in turn invested that deposit into a company that also finance company, which was giving a moderate interest. We thought that is very good. And the second thing is, in addition to that, the management, our company management, had a very good relationship with that particular finance company. But unfortunately, the company collapsed. The majority of almost 70% of the deposit was held at that time. So, we were losing interest. We suddenly lost all the money. And we are not in a position right away paying the way we are customers. Number two, and these are not the leaders, there have been some internal problems. A group of people, they got together. And they have missed the appropriate funds, which the directors never felt, because some of the directors, they didn't have any financial background. And this group of people, the together, slowly but steadily, have almost, I would say, stolen the money of the this group of customers. Number three, sure if our politics, the others, and you, media, build our image, and they're not going to run away, they're going to be able to continue. But we have set up a plan, and also, informed earlier, there were some Indian people who had misappropriated their funds. We have already filed a case against them, and CID is taking care of that. So, no fund, now the directors, all the employees are going out of this country. They will be here. We will somehow pay our depositors, values, definitely. So, you people, please get together and bring our image back. I'm sure you will be willing. I'm so grateful for you to be here in numbers, to listen to our agreements. I'm sure you're going to have a good life for our company and help us to come back to our normal self and not to go down to ground zero. Thank you.
Yeah, I have a question. You said that 75% of your deposits, of the people's deposits, went to one other commercial company.
Yes.
So at that point of time, what was the prudency on the part of the directors to dump all the public money into one basket?
It's really because we were giving almost 30 to 35% interest. And they were giving about 34%. So we thought that is the most profitable finance company compared to the state finance institution. The state was doing single digit interest rate. So we thought we were always concerned about our deposits. So we thought, okay, we should give them and keep them happy. That's what we went for those companies.
You also said that there was some relationship with that company.
Of course, yes. Yeah.
It's not a family connection,
but a friendship. So what we did was, because when friends encourage you to deposit, we have a trust in them, so they are friends. We never thought that they were going to cheat us. That was the main reason we made a deposit there. That was, of course, it's not a well-known company, but in spite of that, we went because of the relationship.
So when the government is offering a single digit percentage, what needs your directors and the shareholders to think that they could have much as 12 to 35%? That's one, the first question. Second one, it is a note fact that you are offering a higher interest in order to pay the amounts due for the low interest. For example, when you couldn't pay the interest for 25%, you borrowed offer them a high interest of 30% to pay the 25%. Obviously going into debt further.
No, really, the other financial company also, where we invested and lost the money, also paying almost about 31%. Why we pay the highest interest to wanting to attract the investor? You know, with this cost of living presently, can you give it a single digit interest? We didn't call it an interest anyway, because we want to safeguard them from paying taxes as well. We thought it wasn't a debt. A credit card company can't pay an interest. It is not a finance, it is not registered under central bank, so it's not deemed to be a finance company. Only finance company can deduct tax. So because of that, we created a credit card company to give our investors a good
from your part in terms like, okay, we can give a single digit, no, we can't. But among the people who invested in you to get certificates, they are dead today.
We are not yet convinced.
I'm talking of your customers.
Your customers? They are not going to do this.
They could survive in a single digit, but you offer them a 35% and they are dead today.
No. Now, we are still not collapsed.
not you are withdrawing from a deposit.
Some other company, yeah, okay.
Deposit.
Yeah, deposit. Deposit that. Okay, now we, yeah, now it's just 2 months we've been dealing. So we are not going to have plan with it. We are not going to, as I told you, we are not going to desert them and go elsewhere or go overseas and try to.
Your depositors trusted you and deposited with your investment. And in return, you all invested with some other company on the friendship. Now, what is the percentage of, like, what assurance you can give the, your customers saying that you all will return their investment?
Yes, that's a good question. We are going to, now the directors are personally liable to it. So all the directors' assets will be sold. And also we have invested in certain other companies. So those shares we are going to sell. We liquidate all those things. And paying the depositors, not as a lump sum, in installment.
What is the time frame?
We have decided about 2 years time frame, but they're going to pay their capital back. They're going to pay their capital back.
You are saying also that for us to help you in revising the credit cards, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So what is the strategy you are using at plan for the merchants to accept your credit cards once again?
Okay, unlike the previous situation where what we did was we take the deposit and then pay them interest. Now we are going to only open a credit card company, not to accept any deposits. That is what we are going to do. Because we have learned a lesson. We have burned our fingers. We don't want to continue the same business. But we are simply going to be a credit card company.
Is Mr. Peter Kudari your chairman here?
Yes,
sir. Sorry, the timer.